Re mai ra e te winui tonue, ngā mātou ako te ao, ki runga te kaupapa te rangi e. Here mai, here mai, whakatau mai ra.
Please be seated. Ana mana, ana reo, ana hoi whā. Tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou, tēnā koutou katoa. Vice-Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Council members, members of the University, special guests, graduands, families and friends. I extend a very warm welcome to this, the third autumn graduation ceremony for 2012 of the University of Auckland. This week, the university is bestowing a total of 7,048 qualifications on some 6,862 students. At this ceremony, degrees will be conferred and diplomas awarded in the Faculty of Business and Economics. A total of 567 in person, plus a further 165 in absentia. As Chancellor, I am privileged to preside at graduation once more. The twice-yearly cycle of graduation ceremonies makes them no less significant for the university and me personally than for those of you being kept here today, many for the first and only time. Graduation is always a festive event, rich in history, pomp and colour, but with some endearing contemporary touches. Here in Auckland, our enviable mix of cultures and ethnicities is evident in the variety of dress and adornments worn by some graduands. Today is one of celebration, hard-earned and well-deserved, by you, the graduands and diplomates, on your academic feats, and by your family and friends who have encouraged and supported you in good times and in bad, and who are here to rejoice in your success. The university, represented by the council and academic staff members seated behind me, and those many professional staff who direct proceedings with unerring precision, takes equal satisfaction in your hugely significant day. The University of Auckland is deservedly ranked as one of the best universities in the world. The qualifications bestowed on you today will always serve you well in this country and abroad, whether in qualifying you for a fulfilling career or in leading to further challenging study, or simply for your own personal and intellectual enrichment. In today's world of constant and often bewildering change, you can never afford to stop learning and honing your skills and capabilities. So do keep in mind our ever-expanding range of postgraduate opportunities. The critically important role of major research-led universities, such as the University of Auckland, in modern life is not always understood. Our cutting-edge research is vital for long-term sustainable economic growth and social development, never more so than in these globally uncertain economic times. Universities such as ours equip graduates like you not simply for the jobs of today, but for careers not yet imagined. The University of Auckland's aspirations for the period ahead and our responses to an increasingly constrained funding environment are comprehensive and demanding. They are taking shape in our draft strategic plan for 2013 to 2020. I encourage you to peruse this wide-ranging document on our website and let us have your feedback. I urge you as alumni of New Zealand's leading university, always to remember your alma mater. We depend increasingly on our graduates for support, moral and political, as well as financial. This at a time when our country's universities receive the lowest income per student in the developed world. Your advocacy and influence are vital in encouraging government and the community at large to fund universities so they can generate the knowledge needed to drive a productive and competitive economy and to create full and satisfying lives for all New Zealanders. That's enough for me on the challenges facing universities. For today is unquestionably your day. I warmly congratulate each and every one of you and trust that you will long cherish memories of your graduation in May 2012. Our speaker this afternoon is Jonathan Mason, who is Fonterra's Chief Financial Officer. He joined Fonterra in 2009 from the US-based company Cabo Corporation, where he had been Executive Vice President and CFO. Between 1990 and 2006, Mr. Mason worked in various roles at US-based International Paper, the world's largest forest products company, rising eventually to Vice President and Treasurer. He was CFO at Carter Holt Harvey from 2000 to 2005, when International Paper owned 50.1% of the New Zealand-based company. Earlier in his career, he worked in treasury roles at Exxon Corporation. An American by birth, Mr. Mason is married with two children, one of whom was born in New Zealand. He and his family hold dual New Zealand and American citizenship. He holds a Master of Business Administration and a Master of Arts International Relations, both from Yale University, and a Bachelor of Arts, Economics and International Relations from Beloit College in Wisconsin. Mr. Mason.
Chancellor, Pro-Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, graduates, families and friends. There are formal and informal milestones in one's life, and graduation is one of them. For most of you, today marks the end of your academic training and the start of your career where you put your academic training to use in our economy and go from spending money to making money. A switch that must make many of the parents in the audience hopeful. As I think back to all the graduation addresses that I've listened to, I regret to admit that I remember very little about them. So I thought, how do I fix that for your talk? And so I'm going to summarize my message into 3 points. Number one. Today is a key milestone, marking a move for most of you as the end of a 15 to 20 years of academic study and the start of 40 years of a business career. Number two, by virtue of being here today, you've learned how to play the academic game well. The business game, however, to talk about life and career as a game, the business game has different rules and skills needed to succeed. So a new part of your education is about to begin. Three, analyze how businesses and the world operate. Develop ideas to make the world a better place. We will need those ideas to face important challenges of the 21st century. So, over the next 3 minutes, I'm going to go into more detail on those points. But for those of you who want to let your mind wander now, those are the three key points of the address. As I think back to my transition from student to a business career 32 years ago, sort of when I was out there with you in the audience, I remember that I had two big adjustments. First, on the mundane side. I hated having to get up every weekday morning at 7 a.m. after I'd got accustomed to my more flexible university calendar. Second, I thought I was overeducated for the work that I was asked to do. It took me a full 12 to 15 years from the time of graduation until I reached a job where I felt I was fully using what I had learned at university. But the most profound realization that I had was that the ingredients that made me a successful student are markedly different to those traits of a successful business person. In school, the ability to solve problems, read and digest information, write clearly, and have the discipline to successfully prepare for tests and write papers were the key variables, drivers, to academic success. These skills are also important attributes in business, but there are other skills that I found are even more important. First, to succeed in business, you have to have a passion and zest for action. To get up every day and to have short and long-term goals that you make progress on. In school, these goals are mostly within a school term and are well-defined and quantified by grades. In business, the goals may be longer term, and there may be more question marks on how to reach them. This is paired closely, this action orientation is paired closely with the second key skills, which I call drive for results, which is an ability to reach difficult improvement goals while overcoming frequent obstacles. Third, it is extremely desirable to have what I would call interpersonal savvy, an ability to work with people at all levels of an organization and accomplish goals by working with others on teams. And for those of you who are in the fortunate position of being academically gifted, where school came easy, I want to give you a warning. If you show everyone always that you're smart and you don't show a dose of humility, you'll actually be less effective in this key business attribute. And interpersonal savvy is also important because I would consider it the foundation of important leadership skills. So you'll reach a point in your career where you start to also be responsible for other people, be a leader of the company. And including the ability to pick the right people, build effective teams, make people want to come to work. So you have to experience the work world in getting to that point. So in the pre-leader phase, look at what works well. Look at what doesn't work well. Look at what a good boss does. Look at what a boss that you don't like as well does. And make little notes, because you will eventually be a leader one day managing people, and you can do better than them. Learn from those successes and failures that you see. Another attribute is patience and perseverance. Your business career will echo life in many ways. There will be some great days and bad days, and you have to find a way to get through both, and as I mentioned earlier, to learn from your successes and failures, as just as others' successes and failures, to become a better, wiser person. I can remember in my own career two examples of one great, one bad day. First, on the bad day ledger, I was at a company for going on 15 years when there was a key position that opened. And I went to talk with my boss's boss about it, and he didn't rate me enough to even interview me for the position. Think of 15 years of work, and he wouldn't even talk to me about considering me for the position. That was a very difficult day. And on the other side, I can remember about 7 years into my work career, I was asked up to the boardroom. There's all the senior management of the company there. And they all opposed. They thought I had done a finance valuation wrong. And 90% of the execs at the table just said, this is wrong. And I spent an hour. And at the end of the hour, they said, you were right and we were wrong. And I, by the way, in the hour, to come back to humility, I used, with especially senior executives, a mix of gentle and humble persuasion skills. But I remember at the end of that day, wow, I was happy. And that's how life is, and that's how your work life, I predict, will be. But my final piece of advice for you is to use your life to be curious about everything in both your business and non-business world. Why do certain businesses succeed and others fail? What makes getting outside of business, though? What makes movies and art great? What do you like in movies and art? Who are the great leaders in world history, either business history or political history or social history? What made them great? How did they have weaknesses which they were able to surmount and still be great leaders? And most importantly, how can we make the world a better place for the 9 billion people that we'll have in this world by 2040, 2050, when, coincidentally or importantly, many of you will reach the peak of your influence in the world of business or whatever you choose to do? This intellectual curiosity and problem-solving skills that hopefully you've learned at university will be needed to curb what I believe will be the greatest challenge of the 21st century, namely how we live more sustainably. As the Western world has transferred the magic of capitalism to the emerging markets and world economic growth has increased, we are also expanding our consumption of finite world resources. The next three generations will have to find solutions to the success of capitalism realized over the last 70 years. So, to summarize, again, the three key points. Today is a key milestone marking the move for most of you as the end of 15 to 20 years of academic study and the start of 40 years of a business career. Number two, you've learned the academic game well, but the business game has different rules and skills needed to succeed, so a new part of your education is about to begin. Getting good at skills like driving for results and working on your interpersonal savvy are two examples of new skills required to succeed in business. Three, analyze how business and the world operates. Develop ideas to make the world a better place. We will need those ideas to face the important challenges of the 21st century. Thank you, Chancellor, for giving me the opportunity to address the distinguished graduates of the business school today.
Thank you, Mr. Mason, and I hope our graduates took on board not just the three important messages, but also some of the very valuable practical advice you had for them from personal experience. This is a meeting of council and convocation of the university for a ceremony of conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. At this ceremony, the Pro-Chancellor, Dr. Ian Parton, and I will be conferring degrees and awarding diplomas. I invite the Pro-Chancellor to award the diplomas and confer the degrees in the first half of this ceremony.
Thank you, Chancellor. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Ian Parton, Pro-Chancellor, confer the degrees and award the diplomas stated upon those who, within their faculty, have satisfied the requirements of this university.
I call upon the Associate Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Mrs. Lawrenson, to present graduands in that faculty.
Pro-Chancellor, as Associate Dean, I have the honour of presenting to you the students qualified for the award of a diploma or conferment of a degree in the Faculty of Business and Economics. To the degree of Bachelor of Business and Information Management, Alexandria Camacho Anacan. Zain Osman Ansari. Shane Ross James Appleton. Timothy John Bird. Marie-Claire Tomeo Sendanya. Shamita Shivani Chandra. Yiling Chao. Hong Weiche. Judith Mathea Collier Westerhoff. Deepika Devi. Rena Jessica D'Souza. Michael Andrew Evans. Fung Mindy. Brittany Jane Enya Gardner. Rushtania Chelsea George. Jialing Gu. Tracy Juliana Hawkins. James Hindle. Adrian Jung. Maya Joy Adrian Jones. Apurva Sunil Joshi. Vincent Ju. Monica Haney Kamel. Salman Khan. Artemi Mikolievich Kavitovov. Pauline Pei Ying Kwok. Jacqueline Mary Nikita Lang. Jing Li. Alexander Adrian Wallace McKenzie. Michael Ross McLeish. Abhishek Mohanty. Gitana Marie Andrea Alale Padilla. Sean Rose Paul Palmer. Suresh Gulab Pabu. Bhavishaban Maheshbhai Patel. Wayne Trevor Potto. Jay Won Siu. Lloyd Marinchenka. Kuljit Kaur Singh. Alexander Eric Smela. Gregory James Smith. Hui Ji Sun. Fotuo Samoa Faithfully Graceful Gloria Takazawa. Muhir Tarapur. Cecilia Bella Tavita. Yi Chun Sai. Li Wang. Matthew Kenneth Woodburn, Daniel Marie Yu-Rae Yuan. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Arjun Singh Cade, and a Graduate Diploma in Commerce. Jiwon Kung. Mira Kung. Murray Kang. Nai Wan Kang. Nikita Akalanka Kariyawasa. Harjinder Kaur. Sukhwinder Kaur. Shrina Kaya. Alana Francis Kelly Curtin. Richard Matthew Kerr Phillips. Skulp Willem Kater. Hai Jun Kim. Min Ha Kim. Serafina So Hyun Rosa Kim. Willem Kyungun Kim. Young Hoon Samuel Kim. Ko Wang Yin. Stacey Kong. Sing In Ku. Andrei Iwarovich Koryagin. Senior Scholar Commerce, Shiva Krishnan. Anishka Jyoshna Krishnan. Senior Scholar Commerce, Boyan Kritoliska. Kridolika?
Yeah.
Thank you. Kridolika. Natasha Shivantna Kumar. Sonal Ravanesh Kumar. Vidisha Kumar. Venisha Kumar. Alvin Kuryakosi. Senior Scholar Commerce, Vladimir Kosmanowski. Celia Vanessa Kwan. Kong Wing Kek. James Sun Sing Lai. Amrita Lal. Nikesh Lal and a Graduate Diploma in Commerce. Shane Rima Lal. Ivy Y. Ching Lam. Martin Ikito Elangi La Tua. Kai Yin Lo. Rhys Michael Lawrence. Hyun Lee. Ji Yun Lee. Min Hyuk Lee. Su Yun Lee. Yun Hee Lee. Chuk Hung Lee. Daniel Lee. Gishu Lee. Ji Lee. Rin Lee. Wei Long Lee. Jiaodong Lee, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Jun Liang. Zhou Yulin. Hunter Liu. Ying Liu. Sylvia Sharona Thailana Lotham, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Shani Chien Lin Lu. Su Jin Lo. Wan Yi Lok. William Abraham Lombard. Bushi Lu. Senior Scholar Commerce, Katrina Hujing Lu. Ying Lu. Ho Wang Calvin Look. Teresa Yanlada Sopali. Sama. Tony Dong Min Ma. Jessica Barbara McDiarmid. Mary Ellen Madiag. Tony Maitland. Tashina Nambiamani. Jenny Mao. Yuhong Mao. Carly Aideen Marsh. Jules Bensi Martinez. Rachel Willona Martis. Sovalini Filai Veha Masima. Lisa Vajis Matthew. Nikolai Scott Matthews. Lana Matic. Sean Matthew McGrath. Christopher Joseph McLean. Ashley Minnell. Senior Scholar Commerce, Sava Mihic. Aidan John Mills. Caleb Thomas Mills. Christine Kaushalya Mishra. Shanduni Nutwalal Mistry. Maria Maltanova. Elizabeth Monrad Hansen. Leighton Leslie Morris. Laura Suzanne Murdoch. Remalan Naidu. Orienta Naidu. Arenial Rajesh Nasi and a graduate diploma in commerce. Mohammed Shoaib Ziyahad Nasir. Vidya Natarajan. Hamisha Danita Nath and a graduate diploma in commerce. Steen Craig Neal. Troy Fabian Neary. Ksenia Andreevna Nikleeva. Kaman Ng. Wing Mei Joyce Ng. Shin Yi Ng. Karen Noh. Jiang Nguyen. Kateria Dorothea Niemand. Farhana Farin Nisha and a graduate diploma in commerce. Rimon Nissan and a graduate diploma in commerce. Jun Hono. Tim Franz Ottenhoff. Yang O. Ye Hong O. Waning Pai. Stephanie Jane Palmer Cadell. Samar Pant. Chitira Parameshwaran and a graduate diploma in commerce. Wee Cho Park. Alex Roy Parlane. Catherine Helen Pallane. Harshit Patel. Mayor Nutvalal Patel and a graduate diploma in commerce. Priya Bina Patel and a graduate diploma in commerce. Priyanka Patel. Senior Scholar Commerce, Yashna Patel, and a Graduate Diploma in Commerce. James Robert Peet. Yiling Ping. Jeremy John Pesky. Quinn Ann Pam. Sharadha Susan Phillip. Geoffrey Michael Phillips. Connor Sydney Gerard Phipps. Rachel Ann Pickett. Scott Alexander Porter. Connor Tyson Power. Priya Arun Pragji. Rhea Shrestha Prasad. Dewashni Priya. Mia Prakusik. Christine Kwa Peju. Daniel James Quigley. Johanna Michelle Quinn. Ras Ashila Ramat. Nicole Latisha Rainsford. Sneha Sharon Raj. Rohit Ramahan. Deepika Rani. Raj Rani. Yupa Darshini Ratha Mahan. Vinil Kavish Reddy, and a Graduate Diploma in Commerce. Amy Louise Redwood. Leanne Haley Reynolds. Zeenat Fatima Rizwana. Rebecca Lois Robinson. Rochelle Samantha Rodriguez. Hayden James Rogers. Yule Anna Augustin Rosady. Lisa Catherine Rose. Amy Lisa Sackle. Nicholas Ryan Sadler. Amanda Pearl Saldana. Joshua Benaventura Santos. Madeline Rose Saxton Beer. Samuel Willen Markwick Scaley. Kyle Chilibin. Christopher Michael Scott. Gemma Eileen Scott. Tamana Siddiqui. Sarah Izzati Sini Muhammad. Myrnal Seth. Elizabeth Margaret Irene Seton. Annalise Rose Sharma. Nicola Amy Sharman. Brendan Michael Sheehan. Georgina Catherine Shelton Agar. Rachel Scher. Xuan Li Xu. Victoria Margaret Simpson. Benjamin Luke Sinclair. Karanbe Singh, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Malcolm Singh. Rashina Sonia Singh. Telpule Sione. Matthew Hui Tarangi Ora Slade. Amy Natalie Smith. Daniel Garnham Smith. David Selwyn Smith. Glenn Madison Smith. Timothy Christopher Smith. Ivan Soltich. Wen Chan Song. Jonathan Chan Min Su. Christopher John Gibson Spence. Mallory Jordan Spence. Krishna Srikumar Nair. Nicole Elizabeth Stead. Lakshan Janesh Stephen. Lena Su. Wincy Su. Alexei Sukhomlinov. Lin Lin Sun. Nicolo Miguel Valdez Sulpanco, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Kanchan Haresh Sutani. Josh John Sime. Venlosok Si Pukti. Tejal Taylor. Hayden John Talbot. Tan Lee Hoon. Zhao Hang Tan. Raywen Yingying Tang. Corey Makaera Tehera. Woo! Salota Akila Panisi Telematua. William Moore Todi. Yong Tian, and a graduate diploma in commerce. In Wei Tian. Norma Tanai. Joanne Aileen Tiong, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Boti Tran. Anna Tamara Trigoweth. Brendan Michael Tripp. Matthew Louis Truwell. Timmy Hao Chung Tu. Alexander Michael Tuala. Michael John Turner. Karen Ann Lobo Udanga. Nicholas John Roy Underwood. Kruti Sunil Upadhyay. Thomas Orasin Baafusuana. Kulainai Papu Douglas Va'e. Ashley Gemma Vanderbeek. Ayla Monique Van Zest. Salisi Tuimon Hinguata De Kuene. Annie Rod Vijamkuma. Mina Tho. Rachel Rebecca Walker. Robert John Martin Wall. Aaron Yi Hung Wong. Philip Chete Wong. Stephanie Yafan Wong. Zhu Kang Fong. Wei Wong. Shuilin Wong. Jane Rebecca Watson. Adele Faye Watts. Richard John Weber. Jiawei Wei. Lauren Andrea Weir. Hayden John White. Bianca May Lynn Widjaja. Jacob Mark Williams. Aaron Mark Wilson. Caitlin Joan Wilson. Daniel Craig Wilson. Stuart Andrew Wilson. Annette Suk Kwan Wong. Dorothy Catherine Wong. Jonathan Roland Wong, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Joshua Ming Ong Wong. Mei Yin Wong. Melody Winyi Wong. Nicholas Nathan Wong, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Tracy Wong Ting Wong, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Ricky Yik Wong. Nathan Michael Wood. Joshua Jake Woodhead. Benny Yu Pan Wu. Ji Wu. Zheng Yan Wu. Pei Yu Wu. Wen Wen Wu. Cheng Zhu. Yu Hao Zhu. Emma Young. Sally Young. Zhu Qi Yang. Yashuan Young, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Ye Ji Yon. Shunman Yi. Qing Yu. Brendan Sean Young, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Nicholas Justin Young, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Thomas Austin Gok Wayu. Jing Wan. Felicia Jane Julius. Ashley Monty Zaragoza, and a graduate diploma in commerce. Zha Yun Zing. Dan Zhang. Zhao Ming Zhang. Yi Zhang. Jing Feng Yi. Yang Feng Zheng. Shuang Zhi. Wei Zhu. Ying Zhu. Evgenia Igorevna Znerok. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint. Niha Kasabia, and a Bachelor of Property. Robert Peter Kim, and a Bachelor of Science. Sumpyo Kim, and a Bachelor of Science. Tae Hyung Kim and a Bachelor of Science. Kieran John Kingstone and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Commerce, Shijia Tiffany Cock and a Bachelor of Arts. Gavin Kartri Kumar and a Bachelor of Property. Jessica Dipinti Kumar and a Bachelor of Arts. Priyanka Neelam Kumar and a Bachelor of Property. Sophal Lam and a Bachelor of Science. John Ronald Lawton and a Bachelor of Arts. Eliza Marie Laycock and a Bachelor of Arts. Jared P.H. Lee and a Bachelor of Arts. Sue Jin Lee and a Bachelor of Arts. Senior Scholar Commerce, Senior Scholar Science, Laura Elizabeth Lees, and a Bachelor of Science. Jia Yin Li, and a Bachelor of Property. Jesse Yuzia Lin, and a Bachelor of Science. Xiaowen Liu and a Bachelor of Property. Sarah Ashley Lockhart and a Bachelor of Science. Lian Ma and a Bachelor of Arts. Alex Fraser Marks and a Bachelor of Arts. Amy Joan McElroy and a Bachelor of Arts. Callum Ralph James Morris and a Bachelor of Science. Tara Raad Naib and a Bachelor of Health Sciences. Roger Kenneth Neighbours and a Bachelor of Science. Nicholas James Nino and a Bachelor of Science. Shivani Pabu and a Bachelor of Science. Shiwon Park and a Bachelor of Arts. Michelle Elizabeth Parkins and a Bachelor of Arts. Lina Patel and a Bachelor of Arts. Joshua David Patience and a Bachelor of Laws. Boris Eftimov Peshev and a Bachelor of Arts. Yu Young Pei and a Bachelor of Arts. Andrew Ross Pilkington and a Bachelor of Science. Nishal Navit Prasad and a Bachelor of Science. Labiba Nawar Rahman and a Bachelor of Arts. Jennifer Mary Reed and a Bachelor of Science. Yun Ho Ri and a Bachelor of Arts. Natalia Amanda Roy and a Bachelor of Arts. Luke Andrew Rutland and a Bachelor of Science. Prope Samreth and a Bachelor of Arts. Joanna Seto and a Bachelor of Arts. Pavan Sharma and a Bachelor of Property. Candice Victoria Shaw and a Bachelor of Property. Alice Ting Chi Shi and a Bachelor of Arts. Liam John Sweeney and a Bachelor of Science. Grace Tan and a Bachelor of Arts. Caitlin Alexandrina Thomas and a Bachelor of Arts. David Francis Tracy and a Bachelor of Arts. Varsha Venugopal and a Bachelor of Arts. Ji Chung Wong and a Bachelor of Laws. Rebecca Mary Woodley and a Bachelor of Arts. Yingying Zhao and a Bachelor of Property. Senior Scholar Property, Edward Yip, and a Bachelor of Property. Amy Marie Young, and a Bachelor of Property. Eunice Shinrong Yu, and a Bachelor of Arts. Wei Yi Zhao, and a Bachelor of Property. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Conjoint, Purva Agarwal and a Bachelor of Commerce. Charles Vincent Bott and a Bachelor of Commerce. George Mitchell Culver and a Bachelor of Commerce. Adam Peter Flint and a Bachelor of Commerce. Elliot Norman Keyes and a Bachelor of Commerce. Amanda Michelle Lee and a Bachelor of Science. Aaron David McQuibbin Sadler and a Bachelor of Commerce. James Roderick Hope Filson and a Bachelor of Commerce. Hayden John Rhodes and a Bachelor of Commerce. Anisha Gayathri Sega and a Bachelor of Commerce. David Joseph Taylor and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jocelyn Carwin Tong and a Bachelor of Commerce. Mitchell Adam Tweedy and a Bachelor of Commerce.
Thank you, Pro-Chancellor, for conferring the degrees and awarding the diplomas in the first half of the ceremony. One of the great pleasures of graduation is the opportunity to hear performances by students from our acclaimed School of Music. Anthony Snyder on vocal, accompanied by Rosemary Barnes on piano, will now perform Sorge in Fausta Una Procella by George Frederick Handel.
Yeah. Brocella, sorge in Fausta una Brocella che oscurar va il ciel e il mare. Splende Fausta, poi la stella che ogni cor ne fa goder, Fausta poi la stella che ogni cor ne fa goder. Vuot allor il porterrare ma risorto dall'errore che pria lì di dolore causa immenso il suo piacer, causa immenso il suo piacer. Sorge in Fausta una Brocella che oscurar fa il cielo e mare. Splende Fausta poi la stella che ogni cor ne fa goder. Stella che ogni cor ne fa goder, splende Fausta poi la stella che ogni cor ne fa
That's a wonderful aria for bass baritone, and it was magnificently performed by Anthony. Can I ask you to show your appreciation again to Anthony and Rosemary? Each year we have memorable performances like the one you've just heard by our students, and if you would like to hear further performances, all graduates and their families are invited to the graduation concert at 7:30 p.m. this Saturday in the Town Hall. By the authority vested in me by resolution of the University of Auckland Council, I, Roger France Chancellor, award the diplomas and confer the degrees stated upon those who, within the Faculty of Business and Economics, have satisfied the requirements of this university. I now call upon the Dean of the Faculty of Business and Economics, Professor Whitrid, to present further graduands in that faculty.
To the degree of Bachelor of Property, Murtaza Hossein Ali. Teresa Beattie. Sophie Jacqueline Emma Benfell Brinston. James Christopher Brake. Michael David Cooper. Yannicka Shock Daji. Charlotte Andrea Edwards. Carl Martin Frankson. Kayla Marie Gillespie. Simon John Gordon. Mark Kenneth Griffin. Michael Luke Guptill Bunce. Kylie Xiao Chi He. Ian Campbell Hogg. Matthew Charles Horn. Yan Yan Ho. Megan Amy Johnston. Vincent Madison. Scott Andrew McElroy. Andrew Robert Maguire. Hadley Mitford Burgess. Christopher Hall Newman. Amy. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce, Elizabeth Dian Yuan Yi, and a Bachelor of Arts. Lani O'Brien. Amy Marie O'Connell. Alicia Faye Joyce O'Connor. Amanda Ong. Keswick David Pearson. Adam Aaron Ivan David Radich. Murray Charles Rendell. Georgia Lynn Richards. Liam Philip Rooney. Thomas Alexander Sneddon. Andrew Liam Sorey. Bradley Thomas Swan. Nicholas James Thayers. James Patrick Toomey. Edward Harold Washer. James Alexander Johnston Wilson. Zijiang Young. Virginia Mi Chun Yu. Luo Yu. Postgraduate Diploma in Property with Merit, Nanan Chi. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with First Class Honours, Declan Kenny in Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sang Jung Kwak in Accounting. Matthew Koon Hong Lee, Marketing. Xiao Yuan Lee, Commercial Law. Ya Xiong Lee, Economics. Ka Hei Gary Lowe, Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. University Graduate Scholar, Nicholas Robert Mitchell in Finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Erica Ruth Myers, Marketing. Yong Jun Paek, Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Christoph Peter Pereira in Marketing and a Bachelor of Commerce. Seidel Niha Pinto in Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Abhinav Prabhakaran in Accounting. Siddharth Pradeep Pradhan, Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Diandra Pramaswari Rahaja in Management. Brendan Alexander Ralph, Accounting. University Graduate Scholar, Nicole Margaret Rockliffe, Commercial Law. Isaac Jason Rolfe in Economics, Bachelor of Commerce Conjoint, Bachelor of Science. Dharavan Sayasan, Marketing. Dimitri Selitskij, Information System. Melissa Dahl Siegel, Economics. Kimberly Jane Summerhays, Accounting and a Bachelor of Commerce. Jason Liang Chun Tung, Information Systems. University Graduate Scholar, Alida Maria Joy Van Klink, Commercial Law. Samantha Marie Vickery, Marketing. Cleo Rosa Wainwright, Marketing. Kristen Yen Yong, Finance, and a Bachelor of Commerce. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Mi Ji Kim, Accounting. Jiang Yue Lu in accounting. Preetha Rajan in economics. Megal Dimple Kanar Shah in finance and a Bachelor of Commerce. Sarah Shen, Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Megan Lily Vettoretti in Commercial Law. Tomislav Viljevets in Information System. Yijiang Wang, Economics. Jun Yin, Commercial Law. To the degree of Bachelor of Commerce Honours with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Rafi Karnik, Commercial Law and a Bachelor of Commerce. Mandeep Kaur, Commercial Law. Hoi Ki Leung, Economics. Kio Tukitarangi Moruhu Kauri Rawiri MacDonald, Economics. Andrew Tengwei Lee, Economics and a Bachelor of Commerce. Si Ying Elaine Wan, Commercial Law. Ying Shi Zhang, Commercial Law. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Honours with First Class Honours, Gemma Alexandra Peterson. To the degree of Bachelor of Property Honours with Second Class Honours, First Division, Quan Hui Sim. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with First Class Honours, Gregory Malcolm Bennett. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with Second Class Honours, First Division, Ruth Layla Dobby. Solvi Marlene Eganez. Hemalathi Sajan. Andrew John Simmons. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies with Second Class Honours, Second Division, Rubina Shaheen Khan. To the degree of Master of Taxation Studies, Kim Marie McCulloch.
I now call upon the Vice Chancellor to present the doctoral graduands.
Chancellor, I have the honour of presenting to you the doctoral graduands. To the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, Trinod Paicha Vonjit, an Economics University Doctoral Scholar. Trinod used economic decision-making experiments with human participants to study how implicit social norms affect behaviour in economic transactions, particularly those that involve a conflict between individual self-interest and cooperation for the common good. She investigated mechanisms that facilitate the emergence of cooperative norms, and her findings in this area have implications for issues such as the provision of public goods, environmental protection, and fighting corruption. Trino. Sandra Dawn Smith in Marketing, University Doctoral Scholar. Sandra explored the ways in which employee narratives constructed the brand of a large service organisation, and in doing so, developed a new way of modelling this phenomenon. Sandra. Richard Granville Starr, Jr. in Marketing. Rick investigated the concept of authenticity and how certifying genuineness changes the perceptions of an object. He used New Zealand Purnamu or Greenstone in his tests, making the results highly relevant to the marketing of authentic New Zealand products and experiences. Mingming Yang in Economics. Mingming developed a portfolio model for a fishing firm that provides information on the trade-offs between expected profit and risk. Mingming. And in absentia, all those other persons named in the Book of Convocation qualified for the conferment of a degree or the award of a diploma.
I now call upon the public orator, Professor Vivian Gray, to present a Fellow of the University of Auckland.
Brian Allison is a southern man. He attended a high school in Alexandra, where he developed the intellectual self-sufficiency that comes of learning in small groups. He took a degree in commerce from what was then the University of New Zealand, and the skills he acquired in accounting and finance found him good employment in a partnership. But Brian Allison was used to higher country, so he set his sights on a career as a company director on boards that make the decisions affecting New Zealand's whole future. The success he had there brought him to the attention of the University of Auckland, which in 2001 invited him to become one of the directors of their Uniservices. Uniservices is a company owned by the University of Auckland. In the same way as any other company, it's managed by a board of directors who set directions for the company, provide expertise for its decision making, and appoint the chief executive officer. Its difference from other companies is that it's not set up for profit, or indeed for loss, which is more usually the case these days. Instead, it exists to facilitate the transfer of the new theoretical knowledge produced at the university into practical applications of benefit to the world outside. Its mission is to identify ideas with likely commercial value and to connect a good concept with a viable opportunity, thereby matching the eureka moment with the market opportunity, as their promotion proclaims. Government and businesses come to Uniservices to find university expertise to meet their needs. Equally, researchers go to Uniservices seeking out investment groups who might turn their dreams into commercial reality. Brian Allison added membership of the Board of Uniservices to his portfolio because though the position did not have a high remuneration, he saw that it would offer variety and high intellectual challenge, and because it served the public good. He was right in his assessment. Uniservices develops applications in a large variety of interesting areas, including bioengineering, education, energy, food and health, medicine, and robotics. It also works for the good. Brian Allison remembers in particular the development of the new anti-cancer therapies discovered by researchers in the medical school. These were drugs that targeted tumours with hypoxic conditions, that is, tumours with reduced oxygen flow, which were particularly resistant to normal cancer therapies. Uniservices facilitated the application of these new treatments, creating the basis for the company now known as Proactor Therapies. The University of Auckland now profits from an exclusive worldwide license for all intellectual property developed as a result of this research and still conducts the basic science in its laboratories. The advances made at the university in the development of inductive power technology also passed through Uniservices in Brian Allison's time. This is wireless technology that can be used to power a variety of types of transport, from supermarket trolleys to model railways and private cars. As a result, we can look forward to the easy life when we recharge our low batteries simply by driving over a pad in the garage, having returned from a supermarket where the trolleys glided effortlessly along under their own steam. The university again profits from this research through the retention of licenses that fund continuing local research as well as local applications of the inducted technology. Brian Allison has brought to projects like these a free-ranging interest and imagination, as well as an accountant's brain. It's interesting to see how these are reflected in his leisure pursuits. He's an avid reader of the complex stories of international corruption and money laundering in the imaginative worlds created by the novelist John le Carré. He follows the arguments of the philosopher Karl Popper on the nature of totalitarian governments as he reflects on our electoral system in New Zealand. A more unusual pursuit, but one involving another immensely significant achievement of the human imagination, is quantum theory. He says he teaches himself quantum theory in order to keep his mind active. I can think of less demanding ways of activating the mind than through complicated mathematical equations. But Brian Allison came from the South, and Southern man has always been, well, a little different from the rest. A popular television advertisement presented this legendary type of New Zealander mustering sheep in the high country, looking to large horizons and distant perspectives in the day and spending his nights under the stars. Brian Allison would never dream of wearing oilskins when he plays his golf at Millbrook Estate near his holiday home in Arrowtown, and he's presumably mustering only his energy when he takes his long walks through that spectacular setting. But one can just imagine him fathoming the complexities of the rules that govern the universe as he reclines there at night under the starry southern skies. They're very deep, these southerners. Brian Allison says that he pulled the plug on his directorship at Uniservices to make way for others with something new to offer. The university respects his decision, but hopes that in time to come he'll remain plugged into our circuit in some other way of his choosing, perhaps even by inductive power technology. Meanwhile, in order to show its gratitude for his contribution while his plug was still in the socket, the university awards Brian Allison an honorary fellowship of the University of Auckland.
On behalf of the university, I now invite all today's graduates to stand and receive the congratulations of us all. And this would be an ideal opportunity for the graduates to show their appreciation of their families and supporters and the staff of the university who have helped them as they achieved their qualifications. This concludes this meeting of Council and Convocation of the University for the conferment of degrees and the award of diplomas. I now invite you to sing the first verse of God Defend New Zealand in Māori and then in English. The words are printed on the reverse of your programs.